This is not a lore stream. This one is going to be an infrastructure stream. I needed to stream something, and since we aren't doing the Sky Factory 4 anymore, figured I'd jump into this one. Just so that way we can see the different setups. Wyatt and I have been working on this the past few times we've jumped on. We've hopped on a couple times outside of it, but he worked on the path that was leading up using some of the new materials that we got from the other world. Sidewalk goes all the way through here. And then he started, so we got these, continuing down. He changed all of the fencing to walls of umber, it looks like, an updated bridge. Nice little doohickey. He really likes the moonstones as well. Walkway leading up to my place, my shop. Oh, I guess it's that, that time of day. We got most of the changes that have happened have mostly been like, oh, let's just replace different materials with different stuff. So, and a lot of times, like, I'm not necessarily the greatest at picking color schemes, so quite a bit of this was actually Wyatt. But occasionally I would give some input. But yeah, this one is... That is an interesting one that I never noticed before. Ah, you could see a portion of the shopping district. Yes. Sorry, I was starting a little bit later than anticipated. I was that's not good. I was cooking, and the recipe took a little bit longer to finish than I anticipated. Nice little layout. I would show you the village curmudgeon's home, but it is let's just say it's in a work in progress. Nice little blue home. One of the homes we haven't yet finished. Sidewalk goes all the way through. There's a sidewalk going up this way now. Oh, entrance to the trench. There we go. Now, through this way. Nice little meeting area for the bell. And this is the main entrance. It says it's not canon. It is canon. It's just a work in progress. This little area down there. Anyway, continuing up this way, some of the more small changes we've done to the houses and stylings. Bunch of fun. Oop. Haven't changed that house yet. I told him we should leave a few of them as vanilla stylings, so we'll probably do that one. Also, there were plenty of other people who worked on these towns, or on the townhouses, so I don't feel like we should delete everybody's work. I like the idea of adding to as opposed to completely replacing. So, although, well, that's actually the reason that I kept the tree. I thought the tree was very pretty, and I wanted to keep it, so we copy and pasted it, moved it. But then we go down this way, and the, oh, what's that? Oh, never mind. I know who that is. Huh. But yeah, another work in progress sign. The stasis chambers, I went ahead and did something different with, and it's not completed, but we will be turning essentially this home here into a stasis chamber. I'm trying to think of what to technically call the building. It's not a store. A lot of this is supposed to be the marketplace. It's not a store. But, I'll come up with a name eventually. Then we have the, yeah, I have virtual desktop on Quest, so I can hopefully play PC VR games now. That sounds like fun. VR games would be awesome. I wish I could play VR games. I do not have a VR setup, and my glasses kind of mess with it, so I have to take them off whenever I'm doing VR, and it makes things very difficult to see or read. So I can't do contacts because I can't have things touching my eye, so that's fun. But this is the forge, where we don't quite yet have all of the people, but you would come in through the main entrance, walk down this way into the bowels of the shop, and there's been a couple additions since I last looked. We're planning to have villagers back in here. We're gonna have to get some more villagers, so it's gonna be fun. Nice little home area for the villagers whenever they start eventually. Let's see what else we got here. The dock area for the forge. So kind of like the idea of possibly getting deliveries in of different materials, things like that. Wyatt did a lot of work on designing the place. I think it looks really nice. And yeah. I technically designed up until this room. And then he added a couple flavor pieces, like the pillars. I liked the ceiling tile. It also emits light, so you don't have to worry about a light source in here. And then he did this one. I did most of this room. He added the accent pieces with that stuff. Oh yeah, my prescription's not too bad, to the point that I can't play without glasses, but I'm pretty sure I have prescription lenses. That would be so nice. And now I can play VR games without them, and I can still technically read, but I have to like squint. It gives me a headache a little bit faster than regular VR does. So we got this one, which we haven't fully finished yet. Not sure what this is gonna be yet. I was coming up with different designs. The idea was the bottom portions are going to be a shop of some kind, with the upper portion being a residence for the villagers. And that is kind of a difficult thing to do from time to time. Haven't finished this pathway yet. This is going to be a pathway out to a dock, as suggested by a couple of other people. Said that we should set up something where like our angler can be out here on a dock or something like that. So we'll get a villager who's an angler, have like a little hut down there, kind of like what you have in Stardew Valley, like I can't remember his name, the fisherman dude that lives out on the pier, something like that. A couple of these that aren't completed, what I'm going to eventually do, because I want to make this a big opening, it's like another archway, I'll be making this open so that way it still leads to the original walkway. again, didn't want to delete anybody's hard work too much, so I only did a few things over here and left the rest of it out this way. It's going to be fun. I've only seen like one shot of the fisher of the fishing mini game on Stardew, but I know the house you're talking about somehow. Well, the fishing mini game isn't completely surrounded around that house. He just has the most, I don't know, the most availability to be able to do so. Got a couple more spots over that way, and this one, I'm going to skip the blue one for now because it's actually almost complete. We've got this one here, which is going to be probably like a town hall type deal. Kind of like that idea, or something else. I'm not sure yet. We'll see. Oh. Well, it's a good thing that this isn't canon. This one, as we listed here, is probably going to be where the mason is. Which, actually, we don't need a mason. I just thought about that. There. Because we have a mason at my shop, and Patrick needs to have a job, so if anybody wants a mason, they can work with him. We have this one, which I don't know what it's going to be yet, but it's a fun one. It's going to lead to the basement of that house. Everyone's falling out of the world. But yeah, I'm going to make like a small basement type thing in this house that it leads to this, or to the living quarters down here. So it's kind of like a live-in basement that leads into this one. Long way home, quicker. That's fair. Oh, there he is. Okay, yeah. And then this is going to be like a food court. I'm going to do something. Oh, laser. Villager bank for emerald stuff. Like a collection of decent trading villagers that require emeralds. That would be great. Awesome. Welcome, both of you guys. This one would be an interesting one for, like, an emerald bank. Would be nice. Hadn't really thought about that. I'll have to figure out which, or what to make it out of the material. Again, this is kind of just a, gonna be building, but first I wanted to show everybody around. Got the, Jethryn. Got this one that'll be a food court. That's why I said it was. Food court, eventually. I haven't finished it yet. And why do I have snow? I don't want snow. Okay. We have this guy who's not very silent. He's actually kind of loud. But he's the security desk. What this place is the Starry Night Lounge. This is why it's pride and joy. It's essentially like a small nightclub that we got. Home of whoever ends up living here. Which actually, I'll show that off real quick. Has like a little storage area for them, and very small apartment up top. Double bed, nice window over everything, and each of them have these little balconies. Bunch of fun. Yeah. I found I'm kind of stenciling this off of a design that I found elsewhere. Thought it was really neat and just did some changes to it to make it work with this area. But yeah, you go past the security guy, and you go down the stairs to the bar and dance floor. Oh, well, thank you, Laser. I wasn't sure what more to do today since we weren't doing the other server, so I was like, okay, I'll just hop in here and do some work. Start the party, stop the party, you start it, and it triggers the floor to turn on. Bunch of fun. Need to stop saying that. I keep saying the same thing over and over again, but oh well. But yeah. And there's also a part over here where you can pick the different music that's in here. Hopefully no music that's copywritten. And then the DJ, or the jukebox right there. It'll play out the music as we go. Pick up the nice dance spot there. This one was fun, because you hop up here, and each chair has their own drink cup, which is actually a flower pot. Got the nice display of drinks up atop. We'll eventually have a villager in here as well. Not quite yet. But yeah, the Starry Night Lounge. Works out a lot of moonstone and then these little star bits. Oh, shush. We didn't actually name him. We just named him Security so he wouldn't despawn. We had an issue with one of them that the village curmudgeon was another character that we had named and he despawned, so that wasn't great. The tree, I can't remember if it was Gale or Briar that had built this, but I thought it looked really cool. So like I said, Wyatt moved it from, it was like right over here somewhere, and we moved it out a ways so that way it was the centerpiece, made it the center spot. And I think the other one that I was looking at, they used a fountain instead, but we got the main stairs going up to the town that way. This one, we're not 100% set on what it's going to be yet, but we've had a couple different ideas thrown around, possibly leading to like a subway station for down there, or I think there was a library at one point that was mentioned. Got a few different things that it could be, plenty of things I haven't decided on, and I'm hopefully we'll have some assistance with most of it. But yeah. Oh, and then the blue one. So the blue one was one I was saving because this is kind of the most highest setup thing. It's got the little like window shopping area where you could see the different things inside. And as you walk in, you have this fellow, the Stargazer, with a couple of these. These are from the, I was going to do Honeycomb Hubbub, where we would have newspapers that recapped last episode, but that's too hard. See, funny enough, Laser, we mentioned Honeycomb Hubbub a few times while we were here. We were thinking about, like, having, because, so I moved the Honeycomb Hubbub. I didn't want to destroy it. So I copy and pasted it over here, but couldn't get the chests to follow it. So it's kind of just up here. But we were talking about possibly turning one of these side, like, corner sections into the hubbub. And, or, like, maybe, like, the hubbub and Fishman Mailman having a possible, like, location here for mail if you ever needed to leave anything for them. Things like that. That'd be neat, having like a little post office type deal that includes the printing for the newspaper and stuff. So yeah, the hubbub has not been completely lost, but I completely understand if it's a lot of work for the recap newsletter. Essentially, it's really cool though. I liked it. But yeah, that's about all that we've done with the little walkways. All of these are I just like the name Honeycomb Hubbub. It works because it's kind of it's a really good alliteration with the H's, and Hubbub really does seem like the type of thing that we do on this server, so. Yeah. Oh, I didn't finish the tour of the blue building. So we have the Stargazer up front. He'd be able to do anything that you were needing him for. This is the stuff from the... not the Rhymestone. What is it? What's this? Turquoise. That doesn't tell me the name of the place. The one place that's all blue. There we go. That's it. I found a village there. I had one of these in a previous stream, and so we were able to use them for crafting. And a couple other... I don't know what that's for. I got the alchemy table. So this is a usable space. It's also like a window shop. Got the bookshelves made of three different types of wood. That's nice. go up the staircase. Got a small like room. We're not sure what we're going to turn it into yet. Nice little balcony area for the interior, which is something I hadn't thought to do before, and it actually, I really like it. The two beds for the person down below, and then maybe one other villager. Nice lit up floor. Honestly, one of the better views. I haven't made the roof yet. Have you seen the food preparation table? I've been messing around with it recently, but there's not a good manual I can find for this specific version. I spent like 3 hours trying to make a sandwich. Food preparation table? I didn't know that was a thing. I mean, it makes sense. There's plenty of other added food items. Oh, hush. Plenty of other added food items. That would honestly be a great addition for this one whenever I finish the food court. I want to look and see what that looks like, though. So it's kind of like you put all the ingredients up top and it turns it into something, I'm guessing? That'd be pretty neat. That is really cool. Not entirely certain what more to do at the moment. Only took about 20 minutes to get there. Everything he makes very busted food, which is great for mining. Yes. That would be ideal. Some of this, some of these. Alright, and then we're doing 2 blocks out here. Wrong because there are pillars made of wall, brother. Why are you here? He teleported without making a sound that time. I will have to look into the fancy food. Also one of them. Oh yeah, so that was the idea for the upgraded gore. For the updated shopping district, that's what it's called. Could not come up with the word to save my life. Dang. Okay, weird. Oh, it's because I was walking over that. Pop that there, that there, that there, that there, that there, that, 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 and... I don't want to make this one too tall, but I figured if I match it with the rest of them and make it, like, a couple tall, that might be a decent setup. Or do I want to do the wall? Well, crap. So it at least looks like a wall now, although it's going to have a different shade wall. It's kind of like what we have there, but walking up here, possibly do, I want to do lanterns atop each of these. Which forces it to... Possibly, is there a different lantern? Ooh, I forgot about the moonstone lanterns. They look really cool, but I haven't used them for these yet, so. Let's see what we have. Moonstone. I don't want to do the moonstones on here, though. I'll just do... And then we continue on. The dock will be over here, which I could make it. I could leave spruce's mark on this one. Use spruce wood. The andesite, that umber, the stairs, nether bricks, don't need those. I thought perhaps Gore was changing something down there. Wasn't sure what they were doing. Alrighty, let's go ahead and do that there. It's terraforming time. Okay, so it'll eventually turn into not grass. Not stairs, it's slabs. Oh, that's fine. Right, so bam, bam, bam. Let me go. Bam, bam, bam. Let me go. Oh, that does extend how far out it goes, though, if I don't stairs. That's fine. here, perhaps, jutting it out. Which direction do I want to go for the dock? So I'm thinking if I do, so I could actually make it kind of like a pier and go extend it out here for if people want to come out here and fish. Set up. There we go. Have that set up nicely. Drop this down into the nether regions of the ocean. Whew, it is a lot deeper than I anticipated it. I think I might do concrete around the base, that way it makes it seem a bit more structurally stable. Can't have a structurally unstable dock in my ocean. It's not really an ocean, this is more of the bay, but concrete. Let's just do like a regular standard old gray. Yeah, there we go. I don't need powder. Gray concrete, there we go. Okay, let's do that. I'll do something similar up here as well. Hello. Okay. I like the way that that's looking. I need to do some other, like, supports, though. So possibly cut that into there. here as well, just for good measure. That one has a trident. Alrighty. Under the boardwalk. Okay, so we got and I feel like there needs to be staircase going down, probably too wide. Everything else has been three wide. I'll keep it going. Oops. Nothing happened. Some spruce stairs. Wire oak there, and not the rest of them. Spruce. Okay, and then we will do, let's say, and then 1, 2, 3, turn, I'll match it down here. Perhaps the home for the angler dude could be down here. Gorfell out of the world again. Upon a time, plant. Plant. difficult for her to the end. Good enough. This one will be a bit easier. So, for dinner, as I shared on my Twitter yesterday, that I had cooked using the sorted food app, the Sorted Sidekick, which honestly, really good app. I would suggest you, if you would be interested in coming up with like different recipes for food, trying something new, that's a pretty decent one. It's made by the guys at Sorted Food on YouTube. A bunch of fun watching their videos. So I was like, hey, might as well give it a try. It's actually really good food. Tonight's, though, was a bok choy meal. I can't remember. Wait a second. I can pull up exactly what it was technically called. Soy bok choy noodle broth, which the bok choy, the way that they had me cook it, amazing. I could not get into the noodle broth. The noodle broth was, I couldn't eat it. I thought I was gonna like it because I usually really like that type of food. And then I finally found one that I couldn't finish eating it. I felt so bad because I was like, oh hey, this be a really good one, I bet. Turns out, not as much as I thought. So let's do. That just to add a little bit. I wouldn't have wanted to do that. Okay, let's do this. There we go. Alrighty. Do this together. The food conversation from earlier made me think about that though. Well, yeah, I thought it would be nice to try cooking different things using different foods I'd never used before. I had, for instance, today I had never cooked using bok choy before, and I found out today that I really like bok choy, apparently, or specifically the way that I prepared it. I like some soy sauce mixed onto it with what was the rest of it? Soy sauce, there were some sesame seeds, some panko. What else? Soy bok choy. It was the soy sauce, the sesame seeds, the breadcrumbs. I think that might have been it. That's all it really was. But the seasoning, the way that it seasoned it whenever it cooked, because you baked it, and it like crisped up the leaf part of the bok choy, which was my favorite, because that was amazing, the way that it turned out. The crispy parts just nice, delicious. Anyway, I'm gonna stop talking about food because I'm just gonna make myself hungry again. I might have to run downstairs and snatch another bok choy. I don't know what it was about the recipe itself of the broth that didn't turn out all that good. It was kind of disappointing to me, but I don't know. I'll figure it out. Maybe it make it a different time with some slightly tweaks to it. The one that I posted yesterday, was it yesterday? Might have been yesterday or the day before, for it. The Sorted guys actually retweeted and included as one of their tweets for the day. I thought that was really cool. But and I felt really stupid though, because tonight, the one that I made, I actually put it in a decent bowl and put it on an actual plate. And the one that they shared, I had put it on a paper plate, thinking that no, that it never would have been like shared or anything. It was great. No, I don't even know. How am I supposed to make this house? Am I gonna put the house in this tiny square? It just needs to be like a hut. So I could see. Let's make the angler have the hut right here on the edge of the at the edge of the house. The edge of the house. It is. Am I gonna make it a 9x9? I could. Maybe I could like separate the house. It's like the sleeping quarters and put the sleeping quarters right in here. Would still need to be the little hut's gonna be a little cube. Oh, hello. It is Gore. Rain seasons. Let's go one more high just that way. Ooh, or instead of going. No, I think it'd be better if I do like a little sleeping quarters inside the mountain. Up a little bit. Somebody made it slightly brighter. Turned to day, I'd imagine. Base part here. Let's also make this a window. Let's go with light blue, because it's by the sea. A little bedstand there, or nightstand there. Doesn't need a whole lot of space. Pot, but flower pot would be fine. Kinda wish I could put a fish in a flower pot, that'd be fun. Oh, what the heck? Oh. Why does that pull up with. Oh, it's because item is in the description. Okay, yeah. Let's see, just a regular old item frame. Let's do that. Let's have a few here for his catches of the week. I'll have it look like he's hanging it on the wall. Okay, what I meant to do. Or actually, I could have them sideways. I'd be decorating like the Big Mouth Bin of Bass, just flip it, like pop open, give me a baked every day of fish or something like that. I don't know. I don't know what to do with me sometimes. Let's grab some glass. Ooh. Though I could do, just to be nice and also kind of uniform with the rest of the spot, is give him his own like little private deck. That'll be the one that I don't reinforce, and it'll also probably be the one that, if I don't reinforce it, somebody will find a way to destroy it, so... There we go. I thought that maybe... I don't know. I know Fishman Mailman is actually the fishing person, so... Or not fishing person, the mail person, so... They do mail. They might not necessarily need to be the person who would live here. I know like Kirby's got her own idea that she's gonna be doing for where they're gonna be living. But I can dream. There we go. Walk inside. I'm going to do a door here. How about if I do, no, not the fish, the item frame. If I do the three up top, this is such a tiny shop, but kind of regretting how tiny I made it. Oh well. Don't need that anymore. Drop back for food. Grab the tropical fish. Grab the cod. It's not going to match any of the rest of the stuff. I need to do slabs. Spruce slabs, get rid of the glass. Oh, there goes Captain. Oh well. Oh, here comes Captain. All right. in case for any reason he ever needed to escape. Oh, well, dang, I thought that would get rid of it. Hey, I think it looks pretty nice. I mean, it's not the Ritz or anything, but it's a pretty nice one. There. Lanterns make a really nice touching, like, or touching, a nice touch to things. I feel like if we have the boats, I haven't been over there yet, so I'm not going to go over there. I have been, but not in a stream. Lantern path. I might have too many lanterns, actually, now that I'm looking at it. I don't know. I like the few that I have on the dock. So you come over here, you got the nice dock, you can go fishing. Make some good smelling macaroni. And oh, there we go. I knew there was going to be an issue somewhere. How about this one? Yep, that's what I thought. I'm just going to do. There. All pillars are all going to be solid, except the ones that can't be seen, because that one, like that one, doesn't matter. Okay. Let's do a trap door, which I believe they're in the redstone section. The homey area. What should I put there? Maybe like the most unique fish they've caught. The puffer fish. Or maybe their special fishing rod? Kinda wish there was something a little bit fancier than just standard fishing rod. Oh, I could warped fungus on a stick. There are technically fishing poles, but no. Sea cucumber or sea pickle. There is. Oh well. I wonder if I can put that in the flower pot. Can I put the super cool. No, of course not. Okay. I can put a flower, and I can put a mushroom in it, but I can't put a sea pickle. That is so disappointing. Where's the chains? Sits low, so he'd be able to have the one up there. This one over here sits low, so he'd be able to turn it off when he's in. So he's in bed. There's reasonings for some of this stuff, not just because I'm bonkers. I'm not always mad. So that one is pretty much pretty good and done. I have to stop with the lanterns, otherwise I'm going to just keep plopping them down everywhere. Okay, I like this. I got something decent done. It took about half an hour. So the diagram suggests that I do we shorten the doorways, which honestly wouldn't be too bad of an idea. And I already kind of did that on this one, so I don't know why I didn't before. That was a weird sound. Come again. Okay, so. There. I like how open that one is. This one I'm gonna keep that tall, except we really should have. Okay. Works, and that doesn't. Alrighty, let's see what else we got. dark oak and spruce, I believe. Yeah, so dark oak, probably. Perhaps concrete for the floor. Oh, I could use glazed terracotta. I haven't done that in any of these yet. Is this the one that's not doing it? There we go. Okay, and then if I do this, I would be throwing in another. Wait, hang on a minute. So, where does this lava lead? Is it just a giant pool of lava? Wyatt, what have you built here? So essentially I need to replace the, what do I have? Soil sand. It's going to become missile sand. Now I need the water bucket. Oak. Light blue yard brush. Sort of matches. So I have a building onto the okay, that should work. And then for the blue wood. How have I not discovered starlit planks yet? I've been in the Everdawn and Everbright. Oh. Trapdoor. I need an acacia one to replace that one, and I need. Starlit trapdoor. Color scheme is everything. Ready for stasis chambers. This building ain't going this deep. This is probably the farthest I'll go, and then maybe dig some, have one on each side, maybe? Wow, talk about perfectly placed. Final results of my attempt at playing PC VR games. My PC is bad at running. Well, that does tend to be the case. When you think you got something good, that's usually whenever it proves that it's not as much. So what should I make the collar scheme? Well, I guess I can just match it. Not glass, I need that. Now I need the glass. That was the acacia. Ooh. That'll definitely be emitting some light. It's fine. It's fine. Oh, that is bright. else is doing it, I can't. How am I supposed to play my KBR when Java Blazers get a copy of Bedrock Edition now? I do not know. I've never played the Minecraft VR. Was it any decent in the first place? I can't help but feel like it would be kind of weird playing this very blocky game in VR. I remember why I didn't use this block for anything now. It's because it is a pain to work with. Shush! I really should have thought about putting him in there with a command block instead of a spawn egg. We could silence him with a command block. Seen videos on it, but it does look fun from what I've seen. You're able to swap between immersive and just playing normal Minecraft in a VR living room. Well, that would be neat. Well, everyone's getting on. We've almost had enough people to might as well make it a lore day. Not going to, of course, but since I am, I think, the only one streaming, so. I'm doing so much work for this. I might just put carpet over this. This is so annoying. I hate it so much. if we were to make it a lore stream, also, I'd have to stop using creative mode. That's just something I can't do. If I had to do all of this in... Oh my god, that would be miserable. If I had to do all of this in survival... There's gonna be this portion. I only use glazed terracotta like one time, and that was just because it doesn't stick to slime blocks. Oh! I was not aware of that. That would be a good use for it. So I use the magenta terracotta next to the slime blocks, since they have arrows. That is also a really useful one. I've used them in the past as like a mural in a couple of buildings. There was one place that I made in a small server with a couple of friends. That I think it was like an end themed like little restaurant type deal, and I used the glazed terracotta for that. Yeah, was an interesting one to be sure. Shut up. Grunt on your own time. Okay, so, thinking for this one. This would be spruce. Just some regular old spruce planks instead of that. I feel like the floor doesn't need to be made of the stuff. Outside, I set it that way. inside, that's where that begins. Close it up like that. Could do like a, I'm trying to think of what I can call this place, something like I'm picturing the Illager, except it's surrounded by parrots, which makes it even worse to listen to. Were you not here earlier whenever I showed off the nightclub? This purple building right here is the nightclub. The Starry Night Lounge. Got our security dude is who that one is. Again, I was kind of mentioning, it would be great if, excuse me, you're not supposed to be down here. If you pick up a block, I'm gonna have to murder you. I guess so. It does have a patron. He just wants to rave. Oh, I forgot I left that on. Yeah, his little, like, dance floor. Rainbow-colored dance floor. Gotta turn that off. That turns it off, and it's up. We're closed. Oh, did he place that? Interesting. But yeah, little place, that's where he is, and hopefully will remain. Okay. And then I figure if we... possibly do a staircase type deal leading up. Make that make that a landing. Stairs, spruce stairs, get rid of the stone. That worked. Crap. Okay. Well, let's do the landing just out one more. And then, like, if I wanted to, I'd put a chest down here or something. Ooh, that would be actually a really good idea. Because then that could be a chest for people's belongings, not a trap chest. So three chests. Along the base, so that way they can deposit items. Security left him in. Or security let him in. Yeah, I'm gonna have to have a conversation with our security dude. Stasis chambers are all set for up to 8 people. Hmm. Okay. That works. And I was thinking possibly to layer this out. Great. It's raining again. It's raining, man. It's no longer raining, man. Have this set up here. I also don't typically use much of stripped logs of any kind. This is an interesting use for stripped wood, though, because it makes a nice, nice like tall texture to it. I guess I don't know. Haven't yet determined what I'm gonna do in terms of walls or windows, I suppose. Not walls. This is gonna be a living quarters as well. For I guess I can make this like a rentable apartment. Have a nice view of. That was weird. Okay. A nice view of the corner of the glass, exactly. Bam. I designed it the same way over there. This one's gonna be pretty much just sealed over, and this entire thing's gonna be one tall dining area. Again, he's spruce that's making this stuff, so it makes sense. That doesn't work as well as I thought it would. No. Okay. So, thinking it would be nice to have that. I do a couple of tables and do them on the white instead of the black. Then I'm able to properly do these. Yeah, except if I put it there, there's no space to walk around. Maybe if I don't know, because that would be too close to the... Play chess but with furniture. Yeah. Actually, instead of that, let's do... There we go. It's not quite as thick. Makes it a nicer table. Make it like an old-fashioned, like an old-fashioned, Dairy Queen. I've been in a few Dairy Queens that had the nice, like, little edge, little bar type areas, and then have this one here be for two. I'm gonna come up, walk in, the nice little seating areas, have everything all set up. For the back wall. Oops. Nope. That won't work. Snatch that. Have this one be the entryway into the door. Let's go ahead and make it an iron one, and we can have a button. How should I go about doing this? Cause it doesn't. Stormy weather is not fun in Skyrim. In Minecraft. Instead of this one having a actually I just had a different idea. What if instead of this having a living quarters above it, it had anticipation is killing us all. Do soul sand. Oh crap. That's fine. There we go. Put that back. Soul sand there. I really didn't give myself a ton of room for dealing with this or for building this kind of stuff, these kind of contraptions. This is fine. Don't you me. I assisted in your creation and I can take you out. What if instead of that one, we just have one there, one here, and instead of there, this could be just a regular old water feature that can also work as a elevator down. violet water lily. That looks fancy. Dispenser with a button. Iron block at the bottom, okay. Block of iron. Wasn't I able to see what it was? Kind of wish that I had memory. Oh, it's because it's a door, not a trap door. Okay. Actually, that could be something that I build into the wall instead. Fancified version. That Horizonite Forge. Okay, there's a lot of stuff I have yet to learn about. That's nice. Hmm. Perhaps go with a flower pot. Couple of a corn flower for sure. And I guess we could try for crystal flower if it'll go in. Oh, it does. Awesome. Cool. And awesome. Then here we'll do a fence. Actually, I'll do a wall. Diorite, perhaps? Crystal sandstone? No, crystal sandstone is overused right now. Well, crystallized. Now there we go. Hello. Oh no! You could still see through it. Crystallized trapdoor. There we go. Set up that way. And then perhaps extending this out instead of blocking it in. I was just using one out here. block? Should I do a pillar? A wall? And sticks? I think maybe a pillar and some walls. But if I did one here, it'd be in the middle of the walkway, so... What if I went right here instead? Possibly here? No, it's out a little ways still. Shake up the design a little bit more. The roof is going to be the biggest pain to do, I think. Because I'm supposed to be doing a roof that goes all the way around. What if I use this color scheme for the honeycomb hubbub building? Purple, black, and yellow. And instead of wool, because this is like a tent. Purple on one side, black on the other. Purple on the outside, yellow. Black floor, purple walls, no. Yellow walls, black floor, purple, no. I mean, just yellow and black would make some sense for a wall. Based on honeycomb. What is a good yellow I can use? I could use terracotta, but no. Concrete, terracotta. Concrete's got the better yellow to it. I kind of wish there was like that we can make gold into bricks, but no, that's not. There's not really anything yellow in planks, stone, glowstone. Stone, perhaps? We have encountered that, so I could use cinderstone and some stuff. Ooh! Can't wait until we find that stuff. If I use black and purple, I could do mossy lunar stone. And then use yellow for the rest. Mossy lunar stone brick. I don't think we've used it anywhere else. Pretty sure it's mostly black. It's got some purple. It's on the opposite side of the thing. I think that'd be great. It's better than regular bricks, that's for sure. We're doing. I'm not sure how long ago you'd hopped away, but I feel like it got dark really quick all of a sudden. I just about finished the dining area. Just need to make an elevator down, really. But walk in here just for some temporary light. I'll put lanterns down. I got the little dining area, prep kitchen, or the food prep tables, cauldron of water, refrigerator, a counter, which actually I could probably do better with. Yeah, so I finished this one. I made a water elevator going up, put an extra table out here, and made a balcony. And I did like a skylight type thing for above the kitchen. Although it's not going to be much of a skylight because there is going to be a roof on here, but it's just so that way it's covered from above. It's one of the things that I like about the crystallized trapdoors is they essentially just work as a skylight, and I like that. But now I wanted to do this section right here as the honeycomb hubbub, and I was trying to figure out how I'm going to use this color scheme of black, purple, and yellow, and then realized that we have a black and purple block that I can use for it. This might be one of the first ones I actually put carpet down on, so that way I can do just some. Ooh, what if I do an amethyst floor with a yellow carpet? That way it has that, like, the chime of the amethyst. And it makes it a little bit more whimsical. I wish I knew what Kirby was making Fishman Mailman's house out of, because then I could do... kind of like a half and half. Let the captain know that I'm using amethyst for a floor, he will come and swipe it all. Land in the berry bushes below. Yeah. Yeah, so the hubbub isn't sitting on necessarily the most secure of land. See, it's on top of this area where there is a fox, right? Where'd he go? Oh, that's right, the fox is right there. He can't get away. There's nowhere for him to go. So he goes down. And he could go over here and come down this way. But even then, there's nowhere for him to go. So he's kind of just trapped. I don't want to kill him. It's kind of cute. But this. So the amethyst is completely blocked. And it still chimes as you walk over it. That's great, I love it. Okay. That one is designed mostly. What if you threw it some chorus fruits? Like, one time you fill in a hole filled with boxes. Maybe it'll find its way out. I could do that, but I don't feel like torturing the poor lad, the poor child. The poor sweet child, the sweet pea. Poor nocturnal sleepy child. He's got a good home there. Use purpur. I haven't used purpur in anything else yet. Purpur and yellow concrete are still on the table as options. Set up. Okay. I'm using the only reason I'm using the glazed at this point is because it just doesn't. It needs something else, and I couldn't figure out what. Dun 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 dun. Muralized wall, that way it's something better than just bleh. But now I have to do that all again. Krebs. What have you? I'm working on some digital art and there's too many brushes to sift through. Digital art can be complicated. I enjoy doing art type stuff. I think the most recent thing that I ever shared was which thing was it? Maybe the drawing I made of Lexington from Gargoyles. That might be it. I very much enjoy Lexington. He's one of my favorite characters. I have to get going because someone is expecting me to show up in just a moment, so I gotta hop off for tonight, but I will, honestly, I might just hop on and do this again sometime. This is actually kind of fun. I really enjoyed it. So, thank you guys so much for watching. Maybe on Saturday we'll see more of this completed. I unfortunately have to close on Saturday, so I won't be able to stream, but I will hop in whenever I get home and continue doing some work, so you might see me in some other people's streams. But thanks again so much for watching. I might hop on again on Friday, or Sunday, I don't know, some other day, pretty before too awful long, and stream again, because I really enjoyed this. It's actually kind of fun, just being able to chill, do all this, and chat with you guys. So, but yeah, thanks again so much for watching. I will see you all in the next time, however that goes. But, yeah. Bye-bye.